Welcome to Google Developers Live. I'm Nathaniel Manista of Google's Open Source Programs Office, and I'd like to introduce Drew Rodman. Drew is here to tell us about his experience with Google Summer of Code. Drew, first, tell us about yourself.
So, hey, Nathaniel, thank you for having me. So my name's Drew. I am currently a fourth year university student, and I first participated in Google Summer of Code during my second year of university, and I've had a phenomenal experience thus far.
How did you learn about Google Summer of Code, and then what made you decide that it was the right way to spend your summer?
So I first heard about it through my college's computer science department. There was a little bit of buzz about it. Apparently, the chair of my department had talked it up a little bit, so I decided to investigate a little bit, and kind of turned out that it ended up being a great way for students to get involved into open source. They may not normally either have that ability or kind of have the time. And Google Summer of Code, I think, provides the opportunity to really prioritize getting involved like that. And so I happened to pick a couple of projects and went with it.
What was the application process like?
So the particular application I chose, I'll speak more to my most recent organization, but the application I chose, or the project I chose, was called Melange, which provides a platform for running open source contribution workflows, mainly Google Summer of Code and Google Code. The way I happened to pick that project, I was just looking through, it can be a little overwhelming for students who have never participated in an open source organization before, particularly when you have all these topics and orgs and whatnot. So I picked, I was looking for keywords, things like Python, Django, web development, things I'm familiar with, which I recommend that you do if you are looking to apply, and ended up selecting Melange and coming up with a project. And through the span of like a couple of weeks or so, communicated with the organization and potential mentors and built up requirements and the project itself.
Tell us about the particular work that you did on this project. What did you build?
So the template for the project itself was revolved around the existing system for connecting organizations with mentors and organization administrators. So the existing system had, you know, it worked, but it had a couple of flaws and flexibility problems that we were looking to address. So my initial project was to go and fix all of those problems and kind of come up with a more reliable system. What I ended up doing, which is kind of a good example of evolving requirements, but what I ended up doing was actually rebuilding that entire system to produce a more robust and flexible workflow for that.
That sounds like a lot of work. Tell us about how you did it, and what was your average day like over the summer?
So it was a big project, and I got myself into a little bit of a trap where I was actually working part-time as well as participating in the Google Summer of Code program, which I will warn you is a little bit difficult, but it's doable. So on a normal contribution day or something like that, I would usually have a current task or design or something like that I was working on. So I'd sit down with my designs for the day, plan out what I wanted to do or what I wanted to have accomplished, have as close to a constant stream of communication to the mentors and other contributors to the program as I could, and just try to code through and design and ask questions and all that kind of stuff throughout the day.
So you mentioned speaking to your mentors. How many mentors did you have, and how large was the organization, and how much did you communicate with them through the course of your project?
So initially the project technically had one mentor. Really, I had two that I more or less communicated with pretty consistently. When I first joined the project, it was actually rather small and has since kind of grown, so I got used to having new members on throughout the summer. In terms of the actual communication, we had several ways that we would actually keep in touch. You have the requisite blog posts for students every week, which is a great way to kind of keep you on task, and it's kind of easier than you think it is with updating everybody and things like that. We also had weekly hangouts, so we would all get together and kind of discuss what we'd be working on through the week, address any issues and questions and things like that. We also have an incredibly active mailing list, and we're always pretty much on Google Chat or IRC, and so I had a pretty easy way to get in touch with everyone if I needed to ask something.
How did your work finish, and what happened to you after the conclusion of the summer?
So my project requirements did rather kind of evolve throughout the summer. It did step me back a couple of times. However, I was able to, with the help of my mentors and everyone, stay on task and get an almost perfectly, or not perfectly, almost full implementation of the project by the end of the summer. It was not complete at the time, so I actually stayed on with the organization and I'm still working with them in order to get that project deployed, although we did end up deploying it a couple months or so after the conclusion of Google Summer of Code.
Okay, we've covered everything that I wanted to ask. Do you have anything you'd like to volunteer for potential students and those curious about Summer of Code?
Sure. Just sort of as I mentioned, communication is really, really important. That can virtually make or break you if you are in constant communication with your mentors. They always know where you are. You know what they expect from them. That can really kind of ease the process for you. It also helps you lay out requirements, which is very important at the beginning of the program, as I had mentioned, as I had kind of experienced since my project did evolve rather drastically. My final kind of little bit of advice is just to have come up with, even if you don't share it with anyone, which you probably will, but even if you don't share it, come up with a plan or a timeline of things that you want to do. It makes the whole process way easier to manage, particularly if you have other commitments throughout the summer.
All right. Thank you. Thank you for your time and thank you for joining us.
Thank you for having me.
All right. Take care.
You too.
Bye. Thank you for joining us. I'm Nathaniel Manista, and we look forward to your applications for Google Summer of Code.